Welcome back on my video regarding building an effective data lake AWS S3. This is part 3 or video 3, which is a continuation to my earlier video about data processing. Now, the next step as a part of building data lake using AWS S3 is data governance and security. Data governance and security play a crucial role in data-like environment, especially when utilizing S3 as an underlying storage solution. There are several key reasons why emphasizing data governance and security is essential. Data privacy and compliance. Data lakes often contain vast amounts of sensitive and personally identifiable information. Implementing robust data governance and security measures ensures compliance with the data protection regulations such as GDPR. Adhering to these regulations is not only a legal requirement, but also protects individual privacy rights and enhances customers' trust. Data classification and metadata management. A well-defined data governance strategy helps classify and organize data stored in the data lake. You need to have a highly architected AWS services and features for data governance security, such as AWS Identify and IAM for access control. Amazon MACI for sensitive data discovery and classification. Encryption options. The data encryption is critical for protecting data at rest and in transit. AWS S3 offers multiple encryption options, including server-side encryption with AWS Key Management Service, which we call as KMS. It gives managed keys, customer managed keys, or Amazon S3 managed keys. By encrypting the data, even if unauthorized individuals gain access to the storage infrastructure, data remains unreadable, ensuring its confidentiality and integrity. Data governance is so essential while building data lakes, because similar to data warehousing environment, data governance is very challenging when you are applying and building data lake solutions. Data lakes and data lake operations and monitoring. The data lakes monitoring is an essential part of maintaining ongoing operations and monitoring for data lakes. Amazon Web Services like CloudWatch, AWS Config, CloudTrail. Let's take a quick little details about CloudWatch. CloudWatch is a monitoring and observability service offered by AWS. It allows you to collect and track metrics, collect and monitor log files, set alarm to respond to specific events or threshold. Amazon CloudWatch can also be used to monitor various aspects of data lake, including resource utilization, application performance. AWS Config is a service that enables you to access, audit, and evaluate the configurations of your AWS resources. It provides a detailed view of the configuration changes made to your data lake components. It allows you to track and monitor resource configurations over the period of time. The third one in our list is AWS CloudTrail. AWS CloudTrail is a service that provides visibility into the activities performed within your AWS account. It captures API calls and related events for various AWS services, including data lake components like Amazon S3, AWS Glue, Aetna, and others. The CloudTrail logs provide an audit trail of actions taken by the users, services, or applications, enabling you to monitor, analyze, and respond to the events in your data lake. In summary, Amazon CloudWatch, AWS Config, and AWS CloudTrail are valuable services offered by AWS for monitoring and auditing data lake activities. By leveraging these services, you can gain insights into the resource utilization, tracking configuration changes, monitoring the logs, capturing detailed activity logs, helping you ensure performance, security, and compliance of your data lake, building on top of AWS S3. Let's take a deeper look at the best practices and tips. While you are building S3, you need to have a very clear objective. Clearly define the objectives and use cases for your data lake. Understand the types of data you want to store, process, and analyze to ensure your data lake design aligns with your business goals. Number two, understand data requirements. Gain a deep understanding of the data you plan to ingest into the data lake. Consider the data formats, quality of the data, data volume, and data velocity. This knowledge will help you to design an appropriate data architecture and choose the right AWS services to complement S3. Number three, choose the right S3 storage class. AWS S3 offers various storage classes, including standard, intelligent tiering, Glacier, Glacier Deep Archive, we discussed in the prior slides. The fourth one is partition data effectively. Partitioning data in S3 helps improve performance and optimize query execution because data lake, remember, data is piled upon, it grows exponentially within a very short period of time. So consider relevant partitioning keys based on how your data is queried and filtered. For example, partitioning by date or by categorically attributes can be useful. You can use an appropriate folder structure and naming conventions to organize your data within S3. Number five, leverage compression and file formats. Choose efficient file formats like Apache, Pocket, or Apache ORC that support columnar storage and compression. Number six, implement data governance. We talk about that in details. Number seven, implement data cataloging and metadata management. Maintain a comprehensive metadata catalog that documents the structure, schema, characteristics of the data in your data lake. Tools like AWS Glue, AWS Lake Formation, or open source solutions like Apache Atlas can help automate the data discovery, metadata extraction, and cataloging. Ensuring data reliability and durability. Number nine, implement data lifecycle management, which is the key. Define the data retention archiving policies based on the lifecycle of your data. Use S3 lifecycle policies to automatically transition or expire data based on the specific rules. This helps reduce storage cost by moving infrequently accessed data to a cheaper storage classes. Number 10, embrace serverless data processing. Leverage serverless technologies like AWS Lambda, AWS Glue, and Aetna to perform data transformation and ETL. Monitor it. We discussed that in detail. A bunch of toolkits are available like CloudFront, S3 transfer acceleration process, all these things. You take advantage of monitoring and optimize the performance. Number 12, plan for backup and disaster recovery plan. Implement a robust backup and disaster recovery strategy for your data lake. Consider using AWS backup services like AWS Backup or replication services like DataSync to create backups or replicate data to another AWS region for disaster recovery purpose. Remember that building an effective data lake with AWS is an iterative process. Continuously monitor, evaluate, refine your architectural components and processes to ensure optimal performance and meet the changing business demands. Conclusion. We summarize the key pointers like the benefits of the data lakes, like scalability, durability, flexibility, cost effectiveness. I encourage you to explore AWS S3 and related services for your data lake initiative using S3. We discussed a lot in this 2-3 videos about how to build data lakes. It's not an easy task, but I try to put a framework in terms of approach, benefits, architecture, and different components to lay around on what are the different segments or sections within the architecture and how to adopt different AWS services while building AWS S3 based data lakes. I hope you enjoy this video. A lot of thought process brought into it. If you do have any questions, feel free to ask me. Thanks for attention. Any question, you could reach out to our email, contact@rctech.org. You know, let's help together build a better world. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, subscribe to my channel, share with your friends, like it. Thank you, everyone.